Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating a minimal design. We'll be drawing out a text using pen tool and give a palette division to its surfaces. So let's begin with the tutorial. First of all, let's create out some guidelines. So using the shortcut Command or Control R, bring out the ruler. Now place one of the line around here and the other around here. We'll add few more for the height, place it here and one at the end. We'll give middle division also. This will be the center. For this will be the center. Again, we'll put some more division. So place it in the middle and the other one at this point. The last one at here in the middle. Now let's draw the text. So selecting the pen tool, just click around here and then click. And here we go, we got a W text. Let's hide out the ruler. So go to view, ruler, hide ruler. Also hide out the guides under guides, hide guides. Next, let's give it a stroke color. Now, let's create that 3D look using 3D Extrude and Bevel option. So reduce the stroke thickness to 0.25 points and change the color to lighter. So let's choose this blue color. Now selecting the shape, go to filter, 3D Extrude and Bevel. Let's preview the changes. Increase the extrude depth and we're not going to disturb the axis value. For this, we'll give it around 82 points and click OK. So we got this W shape in 3D perspective view. Now we'll expand the shape. So go to Object, Expand Appearance and then ungroup it 3 times so that all the shapes are separated. Next, select all the individual surfaces with the shift pressed and move it on the right side and delete out all the remaining shapes. Now if you zoom it in, you can see empty spaces between two shapes. So let's remove that spaces. Select the shape and place it in such a way that the two corners are overlapping each other. In the same way, select the other pieces and place it parallel to the top edge of the other surface. Select the last one and do the same. Next, we're gonna put parallel division between each surfaces. So to create that, we'll be using a trick. We'll draw out straight lines using line segment tool and create the parallel lines using blend option. So let's create that. First of all, make sure that your smart guide is active. And if it's not activated, go to views and check this smart guides. Now selecting the line segment tool, click and click here to create the line. Give it a stroke thickness. In the same way, we'll create few more lines. Your smart guide will automatically snap to the vertices and create a parallel line. Draw out one more and the last one on this edge. Next, select individual lines and extend their corners so that when you extract the parallel shapes, there's no pieces left out. Use keyboard shortcut Alt and Shift to scale uniformly. Next, with the Alt pressed, create a duplicate of this line and place it on the other end. Do the same for the other surfaces. Select the line and place a duplicate overlapping the other edge. Next, we'll create parallel division. So select the two lines and using the blend tool, click on one side and then on the other side. This will add steps between two lines. To increase the number of steps, double click on the blend tool and on the blend option panel, choose specify steps. We'll put 7 steps and click OK. This will create 8 parallel division. In the same way, we'll create out the division for all the other surfaces. Select the two line segments and then on the blend option panel, put 7 specified steps. Once you have completed creating all the parallel lines, next we need to expand all the lines because if you select this, you can see that only the corner lines are strokes and the others are acting as a preview. So select the lines and go to Object, Expand, then click OK. This way all the lines are now line segments. Now select this line and the surface below that and using the Shape Builder tool, we'll extract out the shape. Choose red for the fill color and remove the stroke color. And we'll start off from this corner. click, then leave one block and just go on. Select the lines and the other surfaces and follow the same steps. Make sure to select fill color as red and extract the shape from one of the ends. Next, we'll do some arrangement. So select all the shapes of second surface and arrange it to front. Then select the first surface and again arrange it to front. Now delete out all the extra line segments. Ungroup the shapes to select only the line segments and delete it out. Now select everything and remove the stroke color. So under stroke, remove the stroke color. Now let's apply proper color. We'll scale it up a little bit. Now select all the blue strips with the shift pressed and choose light green color from our second design using the eye picker tool. Then select all the red strips and apply deep blue color. Now scale up the text size and let's add a background. Draw out a square using the rectangle tool and apply faded red color. Then arrange the back of our design. Let's add a text. Now apply a drop shadow. So go to Effect, Stylize, Drop Shadow. Here we'll give Y offset to 0.5 inches and the X offset to 0.3 inches. This will add a nice shade to the background. You can also add nice detail using the full stop icons. Lastly, we'll give gradient color to our rectangular shape. So first, copy the red color value from the color picker. Then apply gradient color using gradient tool. We'll paste the red color value on both sliders and make one of the slider color little darker. This way, we have created a minimal design. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.